Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. You know, I've been talking about embedding Power BI reports in PowerPoint, but there's a new enhancement with this data storytelling feature in Power BI and PowerPoint, and I had to talk about it in this video. So, you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I'm here in PowerPoint, and so I've been working on this YouTube metrics lakehouse, and I want to add this visual to my PowerPoint and add some annotations. So when Adam and Martha and I are talking about these metrics, I can have some very specific information about each one of these data points. And so to do that, the first thing you want to do is use the Power BI embed feature in PowerPoint. And then you need to get an individual visual. And to do that, I'm going to go back over here to Fabric, and I'm going to go to my report, and I've added a page to this report where I have an individual visual that's filtered down just to the guy in the cube. And we're looking at the host, and I want to embed this individual visual. So to do that, you click share, and then you can open it in PowerPoint and it'll already be embedded, or you can get a link to this visual. So I'm going to get this link. I'm going to copy it so I have it on my clipboard. I'm going to head back to PowerPoint and paste it in and choose insert. And in a few seconds, you're going to see that individual visual. Once that visual is embedded, then we can annotate. So this chart shows the number of videos by each host. And you can see we have a lot by guests, some with just me, some with just Adam, some with Adam and I, or Martha, Adam and I, and some with just Martha. And when someone looks at this, it's like, well, hey, why does Martha have such a low number of videos? Well, that's because Martha just joined. And so we can right click and say, we're going to annotate this. And so if you use the forward slash, it'll show you the columns and measures that's available in this visual, and you can actually use those. So if you use the forward slash and press tab, so Martha just joined. That is why her video count, and then I'm going to do the forward slash again so I can add the count, is so low, but she is on the rise. Boom, boom, boom. And then Adam's video count is actually a little lower too than mine, and Adam's been doing this longer than me, but that's for a specific reason. So I'm going to right click here and choose annotate, and I'm going to again repeat this. Adam Saxton's video count is lower because he hosts a lot of guests. And so I've added these two annotations, and it's actually pretty simple, but I had to show you this because we use a lot of PowerPoint presentations to tell stories about data. And it's great to have this annotation feature. So now I can have this available whenever I'm presenting. So they're only available in PowerPoint. They're not written back to the service. When I'm in presentation mode, do they always need to be there? Can I remove them? Well, let me show you something. And so you can see I'm in edit mode. If I go into presentation mode, you can see my annotations are there. If I want to remove those, if I hover over this option right here, you'll see that I have a new choice right here, annotations hide, and it'll hide my annotations. If I go back, I can bring my annotations right back on my report. I like them. I think it's great. So I can add a little more information. I'll put a link to the blog where Maya and her team, big shout out to Maya and her team, where they announced this. I don't think they work with custom visuals, and there's a few more limitations there, but what do you think? Have you tried these annotations out? Do you think they can make your PowerPoint, that storytelling, even better? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If you'd like to learn more about Fabric or Power BI, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, for Martha, Adam, and this guy, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.